everyone, I'm Mandy from Designs by Miss Mandy, and today I'm doing a quick tutorial to show you how to export files from Adobe Illustrator for print and cut in Cricut Design Space. The process for saving standard SVG cut files for Cricut differs in a few ways, so I feel like it's important to know those distinctions if you want to design both types of cut files. Before we get into this video, I want to go over just a few of those differences. First off, when you save a standard cut file design, you don't want any embedded images or clipping paths in your file. Secondly, you'll want to save your file with the file extension of SVG. And lastly, whatever size your design is within Illustrator, it will show up as the same when it's uploaded into Cricut Design Space. So, with print and cut files, it's okay to have embedded images or clipping paths within your design. Also, the file extension you want to use is PNG, and depending on how you save your design, the image size can be drastically different from the way you have it set up in Illustrator compared to how it shows up in Design Space. In this video, I'm going to be addressing the image resizing issue that often occurs and show you how to export your files so that they will display correctly in Cricut Design Space without having to be resized. I have this cute sticker design here in Adobe Illustrator. As you can see, it's 3 inches wide, and that's the size I want it to stay at. It also has a little bubble cut area around it because I don't want my machine cutting directly on the design's edge. Now, with this whole thing ready to go, I'm going to navigate to File, Export, and then Export for Screens. In the window that pops up, you can select the location that you'd like the file to export to, and even have it create a subfolder for your designs to go in, which is really nice if you're exporting multiple artboards at once. For our purposes today, the most important thing in this window is going to be the Format section, specifically the Scale field. You can select a preset scale from the drop-down menu, and if you do, I suggest selecting the 2x scale option. But if you want to be as accurate as possible, I found out that if you type in 2.003x, your image size will be even more precise when it's uploaded to Design Space. Then just hit Export Artboard. Next, open up Cricut Design Space. Click on New Project, and then Upload. Then select Upload Image and either locate your file by hitting the Browse button or drag and drop it onto the screen. On the next screen, select how complex you'd like your design to be. Since I don't want any of my design details getting lost, I'm going to select Complex. After that, you can remove parts of your design or delete the background. I don't need to worry about that with this design, so I'll just hit Apply and Continue. Finally, it will give you the option to either upload it as a cut image or a print then cut image. Select Print then Cut and hit Upload. Now I'm going to add my design to my canvas, and you'll see that my sticker is indeed 3 inches wide, just as I intended. If any of you are like me and have spent a lot of frustrating time trying to figure out how to get Cricut Design Space to honor the sizing parameters set in Illustrator, then you'll understand why this is an accomplishment to be celebrated. Your project is ready to go without any other modifications, and the design is already set to print and cut. So you can go ahead and duplicate the design, or just make it as is. Now give yourself a pat on the back and have fun making your next print and cut project. P.S. If you're curious about the example design I used for this video, it's actually an illustration of a sleepy little bunny named Alara, an original character designed by myself and my little sister. We have a TikTok page featuring Alara and all of her friends, as well as a little Etsy shop where we sell trinkets of all the Bloom Charm girls. Okay, bye!